I went out last night in the middle of the night to pick up two longnosed snakes at two houses. One was in a kitchen and the other one was in a basement. So I thought it'd be a good time to talk about longnosed snakes. So for as common as they are, and as often as people see them, the longnosed snake is almost unknown to most of us. And why is that? It's probably because it has a superficial similarity to a very well-known snake, the California king snake. A mild-mannered white and black banded snake that appears from time to time in backyards throughout the state, king snakes are also famous for their preference of rattlesnakes as a food source. They do look quite a bit like the lesser-known longnosed snakes, but there are a few key differences. First, it should be said that longnosed snakes are completely harmless. They're eaters of lizards, reptile eggs, and small rodents, and I've never had one even try to bite me, and I've held hundreds of them. They do have a tendency to poop on my hands, however, which is gross, and they'll even pop some blood vessels in their cloaca, or their snake butt, as a further way to say, hey, don't eat me, I'm gross, and it has worked so far. I've not eaten a long-nosed snake yet. Long-nosed snakes live on the ground. They're mostly nocturnal, but they can be seen moving in the daytime if conditions are right. I most often see them at night, moving from hole to hole in the desert, looking inside holes to see if there's anything good to eat inside. They can get big, up to about 3 feet long, but most are smaller in the 2 foot range. And they're one of the few snakes that have become really well adapted to highly developed areas. That means they can be found far away from natural desert. So how to tell the difference between a long-nosed snake and a king snake? While some long-nosed snakes are just black and white, most have some red, pink, or orange coloration as well. The pattern is much more like a jumbled, loose, or pixelated appearance, and some have full red bands along with the black and white. That can get them in trouble because sometimes people use a rhyme that would confirm that is a coral snake, so a lot of long-nosed snakes get killed for that reason, but they're totally harmless and don't use those rhymes. Others just have a pinkish wash over the back, so it's pretty visible. King snakes never have that coloration, so even a little pink or orange is enough to tell one from another. As the name implies, long-nosed snakes have a long nose. It's longer and more pointed than the round snout of a king snake. It can be difficult to tell without seeing a lot of both of them or a direct comparison, but it's clear when they're side by side. Long-nosed snakes also often have gray or white smudges within each black band. King snakes, while their pattern is very far from perfect, they usually don't mix it up like this and just have straight black bands. So why does it matter to know the difference? I've always found this question odd, but it's something that people say, usually quite angrily, enough that I need to address it. If you are one of the many people that do come to anger over facts that you don't personally value, you are correct. Knowing the difference between a king snake and a long-nosed snake is not something you ever really need to know. However, if you are scared of snakes, which is probably the reason that you're mad in the first place about something like this, then knowing about them is going to fix that. Both long-nosed snakes and king snakes are completely harmless, and if you find one in your yard or home, it's not an issue at all. You can just toss it outside. But for the snake phobic, knowing the difference between what you're looking at 2 o'clock in the morning and knowing that it's not going to hurt you might be the difference between going back to sleep that night or not. Long-nosed snakes tend to be found within homes more often than king snakes. It might be because they seem to be more commonly encountered in general, but it could also be because they tend to lay their eggs in areas where it's easier to get inside of the home. Flower beds, lantana bushes, eroded material between pavement and the foundation are really common spots for that to occur. Baby long-nosed snakes might get in alongside sliding screen doors. They don't mean to come inside, but when they're freshly hatched like that, they're just wandering around trying to figure out how to live, and that does get them inside sometimes. When baby long-nosed snakes hatch, generally in the first few weeks of August, they seem to appear everywhere at once, including inside homes and garages. Any social media or community group on Facebook, for instance, is going to have daily photos of baby long-nosed snakes asking, "What is this?" and then a stream of incorrect identifications of a king snake. So while king snakes do get into homes from time to time, they're not nearly as adept at it as the less famous long-nosed snake. So if you're not sure and you have some pictures of a snake and you don't want to know what it is, you can email it to us at id@rattlesnakesolutions.com and we'll tell you what it is. It's kind of fun to see how many people have decades of experience with things that they've always thought were king snakes, only to find out they've been looking at something else this whole time. Thanks for listening, and hopefully you know a little bit about the very common and not well-known long-nosed snake.